Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel for Bookmas Day 5. I'm Franny, and today we're going to do the Fuck 2020 book tag. I will leave the link to the original video in the description down below, and I don't think that this tag really needs any introduction, apart from the name itself. So, without further ado, let's get started. Share some good stuff that has happened in 2020 and some bad stuff if you want to. I'm not gonna share any bad stuff because I think we've had plenty of that in 2020. I don't want to add to the extremely negative energy, but I'm going to share something positive, which is at the very beginning of 2020, in January of this year, I met my girlfriend and we're living together now. So I think that's a very positive and lovely thing that happened in 2020, and thank God, otherwise this year would have been... I don't think I would have made it through. Moving on. What book did you love at the beginning of the year? At the beginning of this year, I was working on my thesis for my bachelor in communication, so I was kind of only reading non-fiction books that I would use in my thesis. That's something else that happened in 2020. I graduated from uni. I completely forgot. Was it this year? Anyway, I was writing my thesis, so I wasn't really reading anything for pleasure. So for this question, I'm going to count the first half of 2020, and a book that I really loved that I read in the first half of 2020 is My Lesbian Experience with Loneliness by Kabi Nagata. This is a queer memoir about a woman who, up until her late 20s, I think, has never had an intimate relationship with anybody because of trauma that she experienced in her childhood. So this memoir is about her childhood and about her first encounter with another woman who was an escort, and it was incredible. It was brutally honest, and I think that's why I loved it so much. Trigger warnings everywhere for self-harming, depression, so many things, but it was really worth it and such a great read. A book you were looking forward to that ended up not being great. Do we want to say it all together? I'm sorry, but this question is just begging me to answer with King of Crows by Liba Bray. I loved the Diviner series. I have loved so much the first three books in the series. I thought they were absolutely wonderful and kind of unique and different from the other books in the same YA genre. But the fourth book was such a disappointment. It was so long, unnecessarily, and the way it wrapped up at the end was just chaotic and messy, and like the author herself didn't know how to end it, and she just made a mess of everything, and it was such a disappointment. 4. A book that surprised you this year. Heartstopper by Alice Oseman. I was so not expecting to love this graphic novel series as much as I did. It's about a young queer love, and Nick and Charlie are absolutely adorable, and I thought I was gonna like it, but then when I started with the first volume, I was just swept off my feet, and like in a few hours I read the first three volumes, the only volumes that are out for now. I just loved it, and it was such a big surprise because I wasn't truly expecting to love it as much as I ended up loving it. A book you talk about but nobody else does. I haven't really talked about this book myself because I haven't been filming in 2020. Not really. But at the same time, I've never seen it mentioned, only once, and I tried to look up the title of this book on YouTube and I didn't really find any content or almost any people talking about it. And the book is From Scratch by Tembi Locke. I listened to the audiobook back in September, I think it was, and I absolutely adored it. It's about this woman, Tembi Locke, was also an actress, and she married a Sicilian man. They were living in LA, I think, and they met during her exchange program in Florence. But after they got married, they found out that he had a cancer, and he fought cancer for years and years, and unfortunately eventually died, passed away. And this memoir is partly about their life together, how they met, when they got married and all that stuff, and also about how Tembi had to deal with her husband's premature death, and also what she was supposed to do now, was her place in the world and in her husband's family. So it was very, very interesting, very beautiful. It had so much of Italian and Sicilian culture, and I cried. It was beautiful. A book you want to come out already this year, One Last Stop by Casey McQuiston. I am so highly anticipating this book. It's coming out in 2021, I think in May or June, I'm not sure. I'm terrible at remembering dates, but it's coming out in 2021. It's a sapphic romance. I haven't read the plot on purpose. I just want to go in blindly and just fall in love with Casey McQuiston all over again, because Red, White and Royal Blue was just incredible, and I want to see what she does with a sapphic romance. I know I'm going to love it. What book were you looking forward to that got pushed back to 2021? I'm not sure. I know what books are coming out in 2021, but I don't know if they have been pushed to 2021 and were supposed to come out in 2020. So I'm just gonna skip this question. And last but not least, what book will you think of when you think of 2020? I just said Heartstopper, so I'm going to go with Cat's Cafe by Matt Tarpley. This is a graphic novel slash collection of strips that feature different animals as main characters, and it's absolutely lovely because it's cute and it's funny and good-hearted, but at the same time it deals with very heavy topics such as anxiety or depression, and I thought it just balanced the overall mood perfectly because it's trying to make you feel less lonely, and I think that that's what we needed in 2020, to feel less lonely despite the enforced social distance. This is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed watching, and now I'm going to tag some people because people are not tagging people anymore and we need to change that. So I found some booktubers that I think might enjoy filming a fuck 2020 book tag. I'm gonna tag Armin Reads, Virginia Woolf, Ivy Muse, and Jaded Reader. Have fun, girls. I think you really enjoy doing this tag. As for you guys, I will be seeing you tomorrow with Vlogmas or Bookmas Day 6, where I'll be sharing with you all the 2020 releases that I wanted to get to, but unfortunately didn't. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Please like, comment, subscribe. You know that it's very much appreciated, and I'll see you tomorrow with another Vlogmas video. Warm hugs.